We now deal with the November 2019 paper 2 final exam that grade 12s are wrote the last year. It will be applicable to engineering students also. Right, so I'm dealing with specifically certain questions in trigonometry, whether it's proving identities or simplifying expressions. Right, so the first one here is 5 marks, question 5.1. Simplify the following expression to one trigonometric ratio. Sorry, one trigonometric term. Right, so now let's have a look at what we have here. We've got two terms. Right, here's a plus sign separating. This is term 1 and this is term 2. So clearly, here these two I will have to be using my reduction formula from my cast diagram. So let's do a quick cast diagram. So I got my CAST, and we know that in quadrant number 1 you have 90 minus your reference angle. Quadrant number 2 will be 90 plus the reference angle. Quadrant number 3 will be 270 minus your reference angle. And quadrant number 4 will be 270 plus your reference angle. Alright, now using 180 degrees, then we go in the second quadrant will be 180 minus your reference angle, third quadrant will be 180 plus, and the last quadrant will be 360 minus your reference angle. So here in green I have your co-ratios. Okay, so now co-ratios, we use co-ratios for 90 degrees and 270 degrees. Right, so specifically this one. Now, let's get to term number 1. We need to simplify as far as possible. So, here, I have just sine x in my numerator. Here I have cos of x, and tan can be written as sin x all divided by cos x. Now, what do we notice? Remember, tan is written as sine of a cos, and sine of a cos is being multiplied by a cos. But if I want to rewrite cos as a fraction, I'll just write it down as cos divided by 1. So clearly, now, in the next step, you can see that cos and cos will cancel, sine and sine will cancel, you're just going to end up with 1 here. Yeah. Right, but let's continue with term number 2. So we have sine of 180 degrees plus x. So here is 180. This is the third quadrant, and you see the letter T in the third quadrant. T stands for tan and the reciprocal, which is 1 divided by tan, which is cot. That means only tan, only the tan graph and the cot graph are positive in the third quadrant. Now, you do not have tan or cot, so that means if you do not have tan or cot, your graph will be negative in that quadrant. Right, so in a case like this, sine of 180 degrees plus x, sine is negative, so I'm going to introduce a bracket here, so that becomes minus sine x. Sine is negative in the third quadrant. Now here, cosine, cos of 90 degrees minus x. So 90 minus is the first quadrant. Now in the first quadrant you see the letter A. A means all graphs are positive in the first quadrant. They all lie above the x-axis. But now, when we are using 90 degrees or 270 degrees, then we will be using co-ratios. So, if you have sine, it will change to cosine, which is just cos, same thing. Okay. Then, if you have tan, whether it's sine of tan of 90, 270 minus 270 plus 90 minus 90 plus, whether you're dealing with 90 or 270, it will change to cotan, which is just cos. Then, if you have sec or secant, whether it's 90 or 270 minus 270 plus 90 minus 90 plus, you put a co in front, it's going to change to cosec. Alright, and the reverse also applies. That means if you have cos 90 or 270, it will change back to sine. If you got cos, it will change back to tan. If you have cosec, it will change back to sec. So in this case, we have cos of 90 degrees minus x. Now, how do you work this out? First of all, which quadrant are you in? First quadrant. In the first quadrant, all graphs are positive. So there's my positive. Now you deal with the sine first. The sine is based on cos. Then, remember, you got 90 minus. So if I got cos, it must change back to sine. So that's going to be sine x. Now, here, I can cancel out. I'm sure you can see that this will be 1, but let me just do it step by step here. So what's going to happen here? I got sine x, cos and cos cancel, sine x again. Right. Then I got a positive times a negative, which is a negative. Sine times sine, which will be sine squared. So sine divided by sine is 1 minus sine squared. And from our squared identities, we know that 1 minus sine squared, when we just write it down, our square identities to cos 2x. Okay, what else? We know that 2 cos squared x minus 1 is also equal to cos 2x. And number 3, 1 minus 2 sine squared x is equal to cos 2x. That is the double angle formulas for cos 2x. Okay. And then we have 2 sine x cos x. This is the double angle formula for sine 2x. Okay. So there are 3 versions of cos 2x. And then 1 for sine 2x. There's also 1 for tan, but I don't see us using tan here. Right, so now we know that cos squared minus sine squared is equal to cos 2x. So remember, this angle here is being doubled. Right, now it's not sine squared minus cos squared, it's cos squared minus sine squared. So what do you do in this situation? What you can do here is you can take out a common, you can take out negative 1 as a common factor from the top. So if I take out minus 1, so this becomes a minus sine squared 35 degrees, and this becomes a plus cos squared 35 degrees. Okay. Now, in the denominator, what do I have? Let's see what do I have. I have 4 sine 10 degrees, cos 10 degrees. Now, notice your double angle formula. Sine times cos. This is 1. 1, if you double 1, it becomes 2. It's a double angle formula. However, what is the number in front here? This is a 2. So, this is not a 2. This is 4. So, all you do is you manipulate it. So, this is the same as 2 multiplied by 2 sine 10 degrees cos 10 degrees. 2 times 2 will give you 4. Now, let me rearrange this. However, you can see clearly that this is your double angle formula, but I'm just going to rearrange it just in case you have a problem. So we got cos squared 35 degrees minus sine squared 35 degrees all divided by my 2, and now we got 2 sine x cos x is the same as sine of double the angle. So therefore, 2 sine 10 cos 10 is going to equal to sine of double the angle, double 10, you get 20 degrees. You're clear with that, I hope. It's a double angle formula. Don't always think that it's a 1 here. Whatever the coefficient of x is, you double it. So if this was a 1,000 and 1,000, it's going to be sine 2,000. That's all. If that's a million and a million, it'll be sine 2,000. You're doubling your angle. So in the November 2019 exam, you have to apply your knowledge. Right. So, let's continue. And let's see what we have. Minus 1 cos squared of 35 minus sine squared of 35. Here's the check. Cos squared of an angle minus sine squared of the same angle is equal to cos of double the angle. So double angle formula. So therefore, this is going to equal to cos of double the angle. You double 35, you get 70 degrees, all divided by 2 sine 20 degrees. Now, clearly, you should, from this step here, you should be able to work it out. What do you notice about 70 degrees and 20 degrees? They are complementary angles. They add up to 90 degrees. Okay. So,
Let's let me just take a basic right angle triangle.
Right.
Let's call this A B C.
Okay. So now let us try to do this. Okay. So if this is 20 degrees, how much will this be? Obviously, it will be 70 degrees. Remember, the angles of a triangle add up to 180. So if this is 90, that means the other two angles have to add up to 90. So this is 70, I mean, this is 20, this has to be 70. Now, okay, if I go sine, 20 degrees, according to my diagram, sine of 20 degrees. What do we know about the ratio of sine? It is the opposite side divided by the hypotenuse. So sine of 20 degrees is opposite of the hypotenuse. Opposite, according to this diagram, is AC and hypotenuse is AB. Alright. Now, let's take 70 degrees. Cos of 70 degrees. Now, cos of 70 degrees, what do we know about the ratio of cos? It's going to be adjacent divided by hypotenuse. If you forget, just remember SOHCAHTOM. So this is CAH, cos adjacent of hypotenuse, or in terms of x, y, and r, cos is x divided by r. Now, you place yourself at this position now. Okay. What is adjacent to 70 degrees? In other words, what is the side that is next to 70 degrees? This is adjacent. Now there are two next to. But this side here is opposite 90 degrees. This side here is the hypotenuse. The hypotenuse does not change. Adjacent and opposite will change based on your reference angle. Okay? So don't think opposite is always going to be AC. Opposite 20 degrees is AC. Opposite 70 degrees is BC. It's a different opposite. Okay, so cos of 70 degrees is equal to adjacent. Adjacent is AC divided by hypotenuse, which is AB. So therefore, they are both AC over AB. So therefore, sine 20 degrees is equal to cos of 70 degrees. They are both equal to AC over AB. Now this is just for your understanding. You don't have to go and draw this triangle in the exam. But this is explaining co-ratios to you. Okay. So why is cos of 70 degrees equal to sine of 20 degrees? Let's write it down here. So let's take cos of 70 degrees. I've got minus 1, let's continue with this. I've got my 2 there. So cos of 70 degrees is the same as cos of 90 degrees minus 20 degrees. And then I've got sine of 20 degrees. It's up to you. You can choose to change cos, or you can choose to change sine. Right. So now this is using the cast diagram. This is for your understanding using a right angle triangle. So therefore, I've got my minus 1 times, what do I know now? Cos of 90 minus 20. So if I go to my co-ratios, it's 90 minus first quadrant, cos will change to sine. So therefore, cos of 90 minus 20 is the same as sine of 20 divided by my sine of 20 there originally. So what will happen now? Without a calculator, you can see those two cancel. We end up with minus 1 over 2. Easy 5 marks. Here, you need to understand how to manipulate your expression so it matches your double angle formula. Right, so I'm going to erase the board and we're going to continue with the next example. Right, 5.3. This one is 4 months. So, we're given cos of 26 degrees is equal to m. Without using a calculator, determine 2 sine squared of 77 degrees in terms of m. Alright, so now, straight away, when you see that 2 in front here, you should recall that that 2 is part of your double angle formula. That's why I always advise my students to not rely on the formula sheets, because you will not be familiar with the formulas. You have it in your brain and then you scan one time, you can see that this is a double angle formula. So what do I mean when you write it down for you again? Double angles. Remember that cos of 2x is equal to cos squared minus sine squared. It's also equal to 1 minus 2 sine squared, and it's also equal to 2 cos squared minus 1. Okay, so now the second two are actually derived from the first one using our square. Just that I've been writing it down a million times, so I know it. Right, so now, here is the 2 that I was talking about. 2 sine squared. 2 sine squared. Alright, so now, let's take this one. Let's take it and write it down. Okay. So, let's take this one. So what do we know? We know that cos of 2x is equal to 1 minus 2 sine squared. Right, you will write that down first. And now, this is not negative, it's positive, so let's make this positive. We'll transpose it to the left. So therefore, 2 sine squared is equal to 1 minus cos 2x. Right, so now I got 2 sine squared 77 degrees. So let x equal to 77 degrees, because that's the given information we have. So x is equal to 77 degrees. So now I will have 2 sine squared of x is equal to 1 minus cos of 2 times my x value there. So, what is x? X is 77 degrees. And this is 2x, so it's going to be 2 times 77 degrees. This is all without a calculator, you can see that. So 2 sine squared of 77 degrees is equal to 1 minus cos. 2 times 77 is going to be at 140 plus 14, that will be 154. That will be 154 degrees. Alright, you can check this on the calculator. So even with the other one, you can check it all on the calculator. You type this out, type that up, left hand side must equal to the right hand side. Now, we got this 154 degrees. Alright, so let's reduce it to an angle in the first quadrant. Right, because we are given an angle in the first quadrant. 26 degrees is in between 0 and 90. So let's reduce 154 to an angle in the first quadrant. How do we do that? All we're going to do is And that will be 26. Okay, you can check. 180 minus 26 is going to give you 154. So now, this is in the second quadrant. And this is second quadrant. And cos is negative. Right, you know your cos diagram there. In the second quadrant, cos is negative. So therefore, 1 minus. So second quadrant that will be minus cos of 26 degrees. Your reduction formula. You know, cos of 180 minus x is equal to minus cos in the second quadrant. So therefore, also remember, notice how I'm using brackets. Do not use dots. Okay, if you are 100%, you make sure, okay, all these little things, make sure you use brackets, not dots, not only for this one, for every other example. Right. So, what do we have now? Negative times a negative, that will be positive. And, what do we know? Cos of 26 degrees is equal to m, that was a given information. And that was your formulas.
Alright.
November 2019, this is the latest exam paper. Right. Last year's November paper. So now, let's have a look at the next one. This one. So now we're dealing with equations. Right, so consider f of x is equal to sine of x plus 25, cos 15 minus cos of x plus 25, sine 15. Determine the general solution. F of x is equal to tan, or if f of x is equal to a. So this was supposed to be if f of x is equal to tan of 165 degrees. So let's write it down. We got 5.4.1. So we have, we were given f of x is equal to sine of x plus 25 times cos of 15 degrees minus cos of x plus 25 times sine of 15 degrees. Okay, now we were also given f of x is equal to tan of 165 degrees. Okay. So therefore, I'm going to replace f of x with tan of 165 degrees. So I've got tan of 165 degrees on the left hand side. I'm replacing f of x with tan of 165 degrees. Now let's look at the right hand side. When you see sine, cos, minus cos, sine, straight away, these are your compound angle formulas. So what do we know? When you have sine of A plus B, you could have sine of A minus B. You could have cos of A plus B, cos of A minus B. The more popular ones are tan, sine of cos there in your examples. Right, so sine of A plus B is the same as sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Sine of A minus B will be sine A cos B minus cos A sine B. Cos of A plus B will be cos A, cos B, and that's a plus, it must change to a minus, sine A, sine B. Cos of A minus B will be cos A, cos B. If that's a minus, it changes to plus, sine A, If you compare what you have here, sine cos minus cos sine. Here's a jerk. This is the one. Sine cos minus cos sine. So there's a jerk. Sine of A cos of B. So this, yeah, your x plus 25 degrees. This part here can be considered as A, and 15 degrees will be your B. So there's your A, B, A, B. Right, so therefore, this can be written as sine of A minus B. So that's equal to sine of A minus B. You can see that A minus B, so my A is x plus 25 degrees, and my B is 15 degrees. Right, so now we got tan of 165 degrees is equal to sine of 25 minus 15, that will be 10, so that is sine of x plus 10 degrees. Okay, now sine is 165 degrees, so we can work it out. The question does not state to not use a calculator. That means you can use your calculator here. So that is tan of 165 degrees. Oh, we're getting it. There's an irrational number there, which is minus 2 plus root 3. So this is what the calculator is doing. So therefore, I'm going to write this on the left hand side. So I'm going to sine of x plus 10 degrees is equal to minus 2 plus 3, or you can write it as minus 0.2679. This is in decimals. Okay, minus 0.2679. Now, determine the general solution. Right, so we're only going to determine the general solution. So what do we know? Alright, so here we have sine being negative. Right, so there's different ways of writing down your general solution when you have a negative. So let me just do my past diagram. We got C, A, S, T. We have sine being negative. So where is sine negative? Sine is negative in two quadrants. First of all, you need to know where is sine positive. Sine is positive in the first quadrant. Sine is positive also in the second quadrant. Okay, so therefore, sine will be negative in the third and the fourth quadrants. That would be, you can sketch your graph to see this. So, we've got sine is negative in quadrants. Sine is negative in quadrants 3 and 4. So, quadrant 3. What we're going to do is we're going to go x plus 10 degrees. Okay. Now, the way I'm going to do it, I'm going to ignore the negative sign. We are going to deal with 180. Plus your reference angle there, and here it will be 360 minus your reference angle. If you are including the negative sign, that's a different way of doing it. Okay, so be careful. The method that I'm using is I'm going to ignore the negative and I'm going to use 180 plus. So I'm going to go x plus 10 degrees is equal to 180 plus inverse sine, and I will write it as a positive. So instead of minus 0.2, 2, 6, 7, 9.
No. 0, 2, 6, 7, 9 degrees.
Okay. Plus K 360 degrees. Where K must be an element of Z. Okay. So you have to state this, that K must be integer values. Z means integers. So that is the solution for the third quadrant. So now X is equal to 180 plus that. This you will leave it as is, and this 10 degrees take it to the right hand side. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go 180 plus inverse sine minus 10. I'm making x the subject of the formula. So I'm going to go 180 plus inverse sine of 0.2679, and then we got minus 10 degrees. So I'm getting 185.539 degrees plus K 360 degrees. Okay, so this is the general solution for your third quadrant. Okay, it will repeat every 360 degrees. You can substitute this value back into the original equation in order to check. So that is quadrant. Quadrant number 4. Let's go back. So we've got x plus 10 degrees. In quadrant number 4, we use 360 minus a positive reference. So 360 minus inverse sine of the positive 0.2679 plus my K 360 degrees then. From the general solution, then plus K 360 degrees. You do not have to state K must be an element of Z twice. You just do it once. Right, now let's work this one out. What do we get? So I've got 360 minus inverse sine of 0.2679. 360 minus that, and then take 10 to the right, so you have minus 10 degrees. And I get 334. So x is going to equal to 334.461 degrees plus k 360 degrees. How do you know if this answer is correct? You will substitute back into your original equation. Here is the original message here. So you replace, you take x. Alright, substitute k equal to 0 to get your first value. So the 185.539. Substitute here, substitute there, work this whole thing out, and check if it's equal to f of x. Check what is tan of 165 degrees. Okay, it's up to you to make sure. Use your calculator and check. Alright, so I'm going to erase the board in order for me to deal with the last question. Alright, now the last question, you have determined the values of x in the interval 0 to 360 degrees, for which f of x will have a minimum value. Minimum value, right. Now, what is f of x? We know that f of x is, f of x is tan of 165 degrees. Okay. of x is also, remember, we just reduced, there's one f of x, sine of a cos b minus cos a sine b, and this is equal to sine of x plus 10 degrees. Okay, so f of x was equal to, let me just write it down again, it was sine of, sine of x plus 10 degrees. Okay, so what do we have? We have a sine graph. This sine graph is shifted 10 degrees to the left. Okay, so in order to understand where sine of x plus 10 degrees is going to reach a minimum, it's best to do it graphically. Right, so now let's take our graph here. Right, so you should have knowledge of your basic sine graph. What is the basic sine graph? Let's sketch our basic sine graph. You know, you're going up, down, there, you know, that's 0, this is 90, 180, 270, 360 degrees. So, that's 1, minus 1, this is the graph of y, is equal to sine x from 0 to 360 degrees. Alright, so, where will this graph, what values of x will sine reach a minimum? So now you know this part here is your maximum and this one here is the minimum. So for your minimum, x is equal to 270 degrees. You can see when x is equal to 270 degrees, the y value is equal to minus 1. That's your quadrant. Now what is different with that one? X plus 10 degrees. Okay, now the difference here is this graph, this one here basically is moved 10 degrees to the left. 10 degrees to the left. So therefore, you are starting at, let's call this here a minus 10 degrees. Okay. Now I'm not going to get into the whole theory of sketching graphs, but basically, if the coefficient of x here is 1, then your quarter points are going to be at, if your step values are going to be at 90 degrees. Okay. Let's see. This is a 1, so I've got 0 plus 90 is 90. Plus 90 is 180, plus 90 is 270, plus 90 is 360. So, if I am starting at minus 10 degrees, so minus 10 plus 90 degrees will be 80. Okay, the distance from here to here, absolute value is still 90 degrees. Okay, so from here to here, so that's 90. You add another 90. How many step values you got? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you're going to go plus 90, plus 90, plus 90, plus 90, 4 times. Okay. So you've got 80 plus 90 is 270 degrees. Plus 90 then will be 270 degrees. And 170 degrees, and this will be 260 degrees, and this one will be 350 degrees, and then I'm going plus 90 again, 9 plus, it will be 440 degrees. Okay, so there's a 90 degree interval here, there. So minus 10 plus 90 will give you 80, plus 90 will give you 170, plus 90 will give you
Okay.
So now, you know you've got your positive one there. There's the one here. Amplitude, the graph goes up 1 unit, down, reaches the down 1 unit also. So going up there, down there. Okay. Where is this graph starting? It's starting here at minus 10. At your first quarter, it's going to reach your maximum. Second quarter, it'll come back down to zero. Third quarter, minimum. Fourth quarter, back up to zero. And then 360 degrees is somewhere around here. Okay, we have to stop at 360 degrees. So, if I go up there, that's going to be 90. First quarter, second, third, fourth. And then, if this here is 360 degrees, it is still going to go up. That's your 360 degrees there. But will it come back down again? Clearly not. So, this graph, although it shifted 10 degrees to the left, okay, it will still reach a minimum value only once. Okay. So therefore, what is it? F of x, determine the values of x in the interval 0 to 360, which will have a minimum value. So therefore, x will equal to 260 degrees. Okay, check. Okay, minimum means y reaches its minimum point. Right. Check your answer. If I go f of x is equal to sine of x plus 10 degrees. So that's going to be sine of 260 plus 10, which is going to equal to sine of 270. Check on your calculator, there also sine of 270 is minus 1. Minus 1 is where the graph reaches a minimum. This graph does not have a vertical shift, it only has a horizontal shift 10 degrees to the left. So, in the exam, this was only 3 marks, but you need to understand by seeing the picture. Okay, we do not, it is not compulsory to sketch this. Okay, they did not ask you to show by using the sketch, but you had to understand your basic sine graph. All you had to do was add 260, because what do you want? You want 270, and if you got 10, 260 plus 10 will give you 270 degrees, and that was, there's your answer there. X is equal to 260 degrees, and that was your November 2019 question 5. We will deal with more questions next time.